So we were seeing this picture. There is a very long conductor and we take very small portion of this, which is delta x, which has a length delta x. The drift velocity of the electrons is vd and it takes time delta t in crossing this small length delta x, or we can say in time delta t these electrons move very small length delta x, or we can say this delta x length with drift velocity vd takes delta t time in crossing this length. The area of this conductor is A, an external field E is applied and electrons start moving opposite to the electric field. So this was the case. Now let us see what is happening. Because of the drift, there will be net transport of charges across the area perpendicular to E. So since there is drift, so we are seeing that charges are transported from this side, left side to right side, opposite to the electric field, because charge carriers are negative. Consider a planar area A. Area is A, which is located inside the conductor that normal to the area parallel to E. So that means what they are saying, this area is, area normal is parallel or anti-parallel to this electric field. So this is area normal. This area normal is parallel to or anti-parallel to E. Now, then because of the drift in very small time, this infinite decimal means very small amount of time, delta t. This delta t, very small amount of time, all electrons to the left of the area at distance up to Vd would have been crossed that area. That means in that small time, delta t, these electrons will move with velocity Vd. And you know velocity into time is the distance traveled. It is distance traveled. Let us say this distance traveled is delta x. This delta x is the small amount of distance traveled in a small amount of time, delta t. Now what happens? If n is the number of free electrons per unit volume in the metal. So let us focus on this thing. So n, what is n? So we know that there are 10 to power 23 atoms in each mole. So, and for copper we have discussed that each copper atom gives one electron. Each copper atom gives one electron. So even if there is a small piece of wire, so there are about 10 to power 21 to 22 electrons. So there are these many. This is a very large number, 10 to power 21 to 22 electrons are there in a small wire of copper. What is this n? Since this number is dependent on the size, if you take big piece of wire, there would be more electrons. If you take small wire, there would be less number of electrons. So we need a number which is independent of size. So we take a new number n. N is nothing but number density, total number of electrons divided by volume. So this is number of electrons per unit volume, number of electrons per unit volume. But what is the difference in conductors or in metals? These charge carriers or electrons are called free charge carriers. These are called free electrons because they are free to move within the metal. They cannot leave the metal, but they are free to move within the metal. Now this n is simply total number of electrons divided by volume. If n is the number of free electrons per unit volume, so see, per unit volume we have divided by the volume, so this is per unit volume, so this is n by v, small n is n by v. If n is the number of free electrons per unit volume in the metal, let's take metal to be copper because that is the most commonly used metal for wiring purpose, then there would be n into delta t vd a such electrons. So they are saying that there would be these many electrons. So how they have reached at this number, let us see that how they have reached at this number. So what was n? n was capital N by V. So this N is capital N by V. So they are saying then there are total number. So what we need? We need N. N is equal to simply N into V. Now N into V, how can we calculate N? Volume is area into distance. So this volume is area into this distance traveled, length. This length or distance traveled is delta x. Now what is this delta x? Vd delta t. So N A Vd into delta t. So this drift velocity is in mod, because this could be on either of the side depending on the electric field. So this capital N, total number of electrons, is N delta T Vd. This is delta x into A. A into delta x is this volume. Volume is area into length, and this delta x is simply Vd delta T. So we have reached at total number of electrons which are crossing this area. These are total number of electrons that have crossed from this side to this side. This much length has been crossed. So then there are these many electrons. Since each electrons carry charge minus E, so we have total number of electrons N is equal to N delta T Vd. Vd is in mod because it can be towards the left or towards the right depending on the electric field. So these are total number of electrons. Now the charge on each electron is minus E. So the total charge transported Q is equal to N E and minus N E, because this E is minus. So Q is equal to minus N E. E is from here, A Vd into delta T. So this is total charge traveled in time delta T. So total charge traveled in this time delta T is this. Now E is direct towards the left. So we are saying this E is towards the left, and hence total charge transported along E across the area is negative of this. The amount of charge crossing the area A in time delta T, by definition I delta T. So what they are trying to say, since electric field is up in negative direction, we are taking this number to be positive. Now this total charge N E A V D into delta T, this number N E A V D T. So what is this? So we know that current is equal to simply charge upon time, Q upon delta T, or Q is equal to I delta T. So Q is this, this is Q, this is I delta T, and this is Q. Now what happens? I delta T and Q, now what is the value of Vd? We have calculated the value of Vd, and let us put the value of Vd into this. Vd is equal to minus E by M into tau. So this is the value of Vd with a minus. So when we put this value Vd, see here, Vd is in mod, so let the negative sign go away because it is mod. In mod we don't take the sign, and it was already a positive because electric field was in negative direction. So we have taken a positive sign here. This was negative, we have taken a positive sign. Now N is already there here. One E is here, and one E is because of this Vd. So E square, A is here, M is from this Vd, tau is in Vd, and delta T delta t is from here and this E from VD. So this is total I delta t. I into delta t is equal to E square A by M tau n delta t into E. So we have shifted this mod of VD on E.